Hi everyone, in this tutorial, we'll build a creative slider using Swiper.js and Splitting.js. When each slide appears, the image will animate with a cell-based opacity effect. The slider also has mouse wheel control and an autoplay feature. The design is fully responsive and works well on different screen sizes. Let's get started. Let's begin with the HTML. First, we add the CDN links to include Swiper's functionality. The section has two parts, the text content and the image slider. The intro contains a heading and a short paragraph. We'll highlight these words later using CSS. Now we have the basic Swiper layout and we'll customize it. Each slide has one image inside an image wrapper class. We use this class for the splitting animation. Now let's move on to the CSS. In this part, we'll style the main section, the text, and the slider. We'll also add media queries to make the design responsive. We use the Quicksand font for the text in this section. We apply a grid layout to create two columns, one for the text and one for the slider. We use a different font weight and color for the highlighted text. The highlighted text also has a gradient underline. We control the space between the text and the line and set the line thickness. We set an aspect ratio to make the slider a perfect square. It also has a border and a shadow that looks like a frame. The image wrapper covers the entire slide. This class also helps apply the cell-based opacity animation. We'll now add media queries to make the layout responsive. The section uses 60% space for text and 40% for the slider in smaller viewports. When the screen is even smaller, the layout becomes one column. So the slider and text content will stack vertically. We center the underline by adjusting its position. The intro section gets smaller and positions upward on small screens. Now let's move on to the JavaScript. In this part, we'll create a custom slider effect and animate the image using small cell transitions. We apply a creative effect. When the slide changes, the previous slide stays behind. The next slide enters from the right and always appears on top of the previous slide. This makes the slider look like it has layers. We disable the Allow Touch Move property to prevent dragging. However, we enable mouse wheel control to scroll through the slides. We also add autoplay to change the slide every 3.5 seconds. For now, I'm disabling autoplay so it doesn't distract you. Before creating the splitting animation, we add the CDN links for splitting JS. Now we'll create a function to animate each slide. First, we find the image wrapper inside the active slide. We add attributes that divide the image into 8 columns and 8 rows. Then we call the splitting function to split the image into a grid. We select all the cell elements inside the wrapper. Then we create an array to store each small cell. We shuffle the indexes using a random sort function. We assign each index to a cell using a custom CSS variable. This function runs on the first slide when the page loads. We also run it every time the slide changes. The animation plays whenever a new slide becomes active. Now we add CSS for the animation effect. We apply this selector only to the cells of the active slide. Each small cell starts almost invisible. The animation uses a delay for each cell, so they fade in one by one. And there you have it. We built a swiper creative slider with custom transitions. We animated the slides using a cell-based opacity effect with splitting JS. The design is also fully responsive and works on all screen sizes. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more creative projects. Thanks for watching.